Justin would ever make it. But in the midst of terrible travail, Justin Fatica discovered that God had a plan for him, and there was a way out. Perhaps you know a young person who many have given up on. Justin will tell you, do not despair. God has a way out for your son or your daughter as well. Today, we'll meet Justin Fatica, who now ministers to people across the world with one simple message. God is love. Love is God. And if we don't know love, we don't know God. And people by the thousands are responding to his message because it is the truth. Let's meet Justin Fatica. Justin, welcome to Women of Grace. I'm so glad you're here.
Thanks a lot. I'm excited to be here, and I'm just humbled by the words that you've already shared. You know, like I tell everybody, I don't deserve, what God has done, but I appreciate it, and I appreciate your kindness, and it's exciting to be here. It's humbling.
Well, you know, we met each other at a tent revival.
Yeah.
There are such things for Catholics, friends.
Yep.
Catholic tent
that's
revival.
For sure.
We'll tell you how to get one going in your community, won't we?
We'll get it going, that's for sure.
We'll get it going. You got
yeah,
that right.
Yeah.
And we had such fun at that tent revival. And it was a marvelous opportunity to have this great occasion to meet each other.
Yep.
And when I heard you preach up there, you know, I said, I got to get this young man onto the program so everybody else can hear about him too, although many, many thousands of people already know about you and you're busy as a bee. But we also want to get your message out there because it's an important message. And there's parents watching today, Justin, and we're reading those words at the top of that show and they're saying, that's my kid.
Yeah.
That's my kid. You weren't a nice boy when you were growing up.
No. I even ripped on priests. EWTN definitely wouldn't like that. Nah, that's the worst sin, you know. And I just was about me. You know, at 16 years old, I had a Jeep Wrangler with a soft top. You know what I mean? I really didn't care about anybody but how I felt, what I was going through, the challenges I faced, the struggles I had in school. And I didn't realize by me focusing so much on me, I was hurting so many people.
Yeah.
You know, the middle of sin is S-I-N, you know what
yeah.
I mean? And I definitely was an I person. And a me person, so.
Well, what made you so hard? You know, the name of your book is Hard as Nails.
Yeah.
What made you such a hard young man? Almost the kind of kid that, you know, you're trying so hard to get
yeah,
through
yeah.
and it's just bouncing off of him.
You know, when you're a kid growing up and like all the things that are praised, you know, you were never good enough. You know, in school, you know, my sister goes to Boston College. It's great, you know, great for her, but look at me, like, I can barely pass English, you know what I mean? Now I got a book, but who knows about that, you know? But, you know, and struggling with the things that the world looked at as so positive, I would give it my all, and every time it seemed like I just didn't do enough. And my mom would be there to encourage me and what have you, but growing up, I was always a sensitive kid. You know, I was always the kid that would, you know, get in a fight with my brother and act all tough and then go up in my room and cry. You know, I'd go play tackle football on, like, you know, a concrete street. You know what I mean? Everybody, oh, Fatica's so tough. But they didn't know when I had those scrapes and burns that I was up in my room crying. You know, they didn't know that, you know, when you fail a test and you pretend that you pretend that you don't care. But they didn't know what I felt like when I went home and people always like, oh, you sound like Rocky. You know, yeah. I always tell people, like, they go, well, you sound like Rocky. What's that all about? I go, because when I was 10, 11, 12 years old, you know what I mean? Like, I'd be like, when no one's around, I throw the Rocky movie out because it always made me feel good. And then I end up sounding like him, you know? So, you know, I really was looking for encouragement. I was looking for hope. I was looking for love. And sure, my family was there, but as St. Augustine says, you know, our hearts are restless until we rest with God. And I was hurting. And, you know, my family was very, you know, cafeteria Catholic, you know, not like gung-ho Jesus, you know, commitment to Jesus. It was a social thing as a Catholic family. And I really never got it. So it was a struggle for me. And, you know, it was a challenge and it hurt.
Yeah, you know, and here's the deal, though. Your parents sent you to Catholic school. You went
yep,
to Cathedral High School,
yep.
right?
In yep, Cathedral
Erie?
Prep. Yep, Erie, Pennsylvania. Yep,
yep Erie, Pennsylvania. You met a priest there.
Yeah, I didn't like him.
Yeah, I don't think he liked you either.
No, I don't think so either. We went at it back and forth my junior year of high school. Father Larry Richards, some of you might know him. And we went back and forth. You know, I used to call him Meatball because he had a little pop belly. Oh, look at that Meatball, you know, to his face. And I'll never forget, he wrote a note to me during Christmas time. And this is what he says, you know, like, I actually don't remember. I don't want to be this big a jerk. But he says that I read the letter out loud in front of the whole class like it was like corny to write nice things to somebody. Mm-hmm. And what people don't know is that he just had his 50th birthday, and I was ripping on that letter. And I know out there a lot of you, your kids are ripping on you because you're telling you love them. Yeah. They're not ripping on you because they hate you. They're ripping on you because they're struggling with loving themselves.
Yeah.
And they're not saying, you're stupid for praying for me. I don't want to pray. I don't want to. They're not telling you you're stupid because you're stupid. They feel like they're stupid. Don't go tell them that. But know that keep praying for them. Yeah. Keep loving them. Because I kept that letter. And it was his 50th birthday. I just took him out to lunch two months ago. And I said, gave him this big cross, and I go, hey, Father, you know, all the crosses you've been through in your life. He goes, oh, thanks, God. And I go, you see that? He goes, yeah, that's the letter I gave you, because I kept it, because when I went home, I cried and read it.
Yeah.
But people don't want to share that, and I was always sensitive and always looked at as a wimpy thing. You know, I can bench press 315 pounds. I only weigh 160, 165 pounds, you know. I come off as, you know, like people meet me and go, that's been probably one of my biggest challenges is bringing the message to the world, is that they meet me and go, this guy can't do this for a living. Are you serious? He's a joke. He's just a sales guy, whatever, you know. And it's been hard because it's my heart that matters, and it's your heart that matters.
Yeah.
And only God can judge the heart. And, you know, even Father Larry, he's been through so much and rejection and being dissed, you know, by diocese or whoever. But he kept on pressing forward. Yeah. He didn't give up, and he showed me that. And it was him that started it. And then I had a Dawson youth director, Greg Schleter, and a great bishop. And probably over 30 priests in the Diocese of Erie, you know, that really, I consider myself an Erie, Pennsylvania native son of Erie. Because Erie, like, for St. Paul and Jerusalem, you know, like for all these guys, yeah. that's what changed their life.
Yeah. You know, and you had a moment that changed your life too.
Yeah.
You want to tell us about that?
Yeah, you know, I used to my father go, why don't you come on a retreat, Fatika? And I was like, yeah, I already know Jesus. I've been going to Catholic school my whole life. He goes, oh, really? You know Jesus, Fatika. Why don't you tell us some? Why don't you teach us something about him? You know, and I was the guy who I'd, you know, mess around and the whole day. I remember I ended up, because I wanted to miss a day of school, I ended up going to see the Pope in New York City when he came to New York, Pope John Paul II. And, you know, to mess with Father Larry, I get up on top of a garbage can, you know, like, yeah. Right? I never knew this was going to be a prophetic thing because I've done it before in real life now. But I get up on top of this garbage can going to the Statue of Liberty. You know, you go on the, you know, little express, you know, ship there over to the statue.
Yeah.
And we get up by there, and I get up on the guy, go, everyone listen up to me. And all of a sudden the whole, like, you're talking thousands of people are listening. I go, let me tell you something. I go, you know what? We need to love Jesus first, others second, and yourself last. Like, busting Father Larry's chops, because he used to always say it. And then I said, and atheists out there, we don't like ya. You know, and like, he's like, get down from here, and this and that. So I used to drive him nuts, even mess the whole deal. And I knew he cared, but I never wanted to show him my face, who I really was.
Yeah.
You see, young people and adults, let's not play games. I'll be honest.
Yeah.
Adults are more fake in my world than young people. Young people will be real in 20 seconds. Adults will be real in 2 years. You know, the reality is we need to be authentic and real and pour our hearts out. Well, I wasn't ready to face that. Well, I ended up having a party at my house, and we had a hot tub, you know, the whole deal, and I messed up, and I ended up thinking that I got a girl pregnant. And I never had sex before. I really actually was, you know, a pretty pure-hearted kid, even though I played the game like I wasn't. And When I got that call about 2.5-3 weeks later from the girl's friend saying that, not once in my life did I ever realize that what I did mattered. That every decision I made was a seed planted to hurt somebody or help somebody. And I cried at my pillow that night and told my friend. He goes, "Yeah, I told you so. That wasn't a smart idea, you know." And Father Larry came in. He tells the story. He said, I was praying that morning, and God said, "Ask Fatika to go on that retreat." And Father Larry said, "Heck no. I don't like him." Hmm. Well, he asked me.
Of course he did.
Yeah, even though that he didn't like me.
Yeah.
And I ended up going on that retreat, and it was Teens Encounter Christ. And I went to confession. Not that I lied in confession all those years. You know what I mean? But, like, you know, you hold some things back and stuff, you know, until you're really sincere. And I went to confession for real the first time. And like James 5:16 says, when we confess our sins to one another, we're healed. And I was never the same after that confession. My dad says it like this. He goes, "Well, he was a jerk when he left to go on that retreat, and then he came back a jerk that just loved Christ so much." You know, like, and I just wanted to love Christ and do anything I could for him. I'd pull guys in all boys school in. We'd fill up the chapel for mass, and you know, I'd tell Father, "I'm gonna do anything I can." He goes, "All right, settle down, son." You know, like, and I'd like give it all I got. It was my dream, you know, like to bring Christ to every person I meet. And I sit up here, a guy who got 820 on his SATs, who failed in English and failed in Spanish and failed so many times in school, went to summer school and struggled. And I look to all you and say, you know what? God can use anyone.
That's right.
And that's why I'll never, ever not look at someone and not look at them and go, "You're amazing."
Well, you know, I got to say, Justin, that you're amazing. Mm-hmm. You're absolutely amazing. And you ended up with a master's degree. Right? You've written books. You preach all over the country. Nobody can hear you and doubt your sincerity and your authenticity. Nobody can watch you this moment and see these tears on this set and think this kid's a poser. Everybody knows who you are. And your heart's as big as the ocean. And people are filling it up. And you're pouring it back out again. And God has had and is demonstrating the tremendous mission that He's entrusted to you.